So the men decided to abandon their search, and as night began to fall, the great wolf came out of his lair. His teeth glittered in the moonlight and...
There are no wolves anymore. Wolves are just there to frighten children.
Yes, there are, my boy. There are still several.
Well, maybe in the zoo. Ah! Aren't they funny? Grandpapa, what else do squirrels eat?
Oh, they eat seeds, acorns, beechnuts, and pine cones.
And the squirrels? Who eats them?
Sometimes it's the falcons, but more often than not, it's the foxes.
Then who eats the foxes?
Men kill them when they can for their fur, but above all because the foxes eat their chickens.
And we like to eat the chickens ourselves. If the small are eaten by the big ones, then who eats the big ones?
Well, sometimes it's man, but you'd be surprised how often it's those smaller than themselves. Usually, smaller creatures are gobbled up by bigger ones. But it can happen that the smallest eat the biggest.
But that's just like a big circle. It must all begin somewhere, Grandpapa.
You're right, my boy. Everything has a beginning. And to make it happen, the Creator gave us the sun.
The sun? But why? How does that work? I mean...
Oh, yes, the sun. Without it, Earth would be a dead planet, like masses of other planets.
Hello there, I'm Photon. I'm a light particle. You do remember me, don't you? How could you forget me? You have? Oh, please do try very hard to remember. Photon. Right, that's me. Well, anyway, the other photons and I, we transport energy. Would you like to see, huh? Did you see that shot of energy I gave him? Great, huh? Oh, yes, it's thanks to me that energy, in fact, that life exists. Well, what I meant was, I mean, it's thanks to us, and yet we're so tiny, so very, very tiny, that it's impossible to see us. But believe me, we certainly make our presence felt.
But, Grandpapa, please explain, how does everything begin with the sun?
It's because the sun is the basis of all food chains. It's the sun's heat that develops everything which is nourishing. Without the sun, there would be none of this. Would you like another example?
Oh, yes, please, I would.
You see, there's nothing much happening in this leaf, huh? Peaceful, isn't it? But believe me, there'll soon be fireworks.
Now, that's enough. We'll have a bit of order here, please, if you don't mind.
What do you think of that?
And a comb in there, not that.
Another oxygen. Yes, like that. Prettier.
Hey! Are you crazy? I said sugar. Do you call that sugar?
But it's pretty, don't you think, Chief?
I want sugars, do you understand?
We'd better drop it. He doesn't know anything about abstract sculpture.
Carbon,
and oxygen,
and the hydrogen, and oxygen, and oxygen. All done.
Yes, that's a bit more like a sugar should look like. Good. Send it down here.
Thank you.
Yes, indeed. It's sunlight that provides the energy needed for the maintenance of life, for the whole chain of life.
And what about us? What's our place in the chain? I mean, nobody eats us, do they? And we eat lots of things.
Much more than we really need to, yes. It hasn't always been like that, though. Let me tell you about it. Tens of thousands of years ago...
Supper for you and the children.
Call this supper?
Well, I almost caught an enormous animal this big, but...
Look, you and your hunting stories.
Mm-hmm. Remember not to make any noise.
My boy, with that lifestyle, they were always hungry, and their bodily needs were difficult to satisfy.
Fats, 12 calories. Proteins, 8. Vitamins. Ooh, there are very few. There aren't many vitamins, are there? Oh, well, fortunately, we are used to Spartan diets. Okay, all in order. Let them through. Let them all through. All the same, a little bit more food wouldn't do any harm.
Oh, look at that. At last, some proteins and a little fat for the reserves. And it's about time, too. The reserves were exhausted.
Not surprising after 2 days without food.
Yes, and have you noticed there isn't very much vitamin C in that lot, is there?
Oh. Is that bad?
I don't know. We'll have to ask, Oh, well, he's still asleep.
Ooh. Well, help me out of here!
Upsy-daisy! What's happening, Professor?
What's going on?
I've seen this sort of thing happen before. If that artery should burst, well then, we'll have blood pouring out, and that could be very dangerous. It must be repaired quickly.
Move it, guys. We've got to block that hole right now. All right, Blocko, to work, big man. And do block it. Come on, this way, come along. Hey, Blocky, stop dreaming. We're going to need you soon. And what do you think you're doing here?
On to me. I'm going to check if it'll hold before the others arrive.
Got you.
Okay, you can come.
Come along.
That's what I call a fine piece of work, and don't you tell me these platelets aren't any good.
All the same, it's not normal. Blood vessels shouldn't degenerate like that.
Hmm? Huh? Hey, what?
Maestro.
Maestro, it's very urgent.
Hey, what's the matter?
We've been informed that there's a total lack of vitamin C in the system. Is that important?
What? Is that important? It's crucial. Yes, without it, we have fever, anemia, the blood vessels degenerate, and that causes hemorrhages. It's scurvy. Oh, very serious disease.
But then, Maestro, you must quickly order some vitamin C to be made.
No, alas, we cannot. The body doesn't manufacture vitamin C. It has to be brought in from outside, from fruits and vegetables.
Well, what are we going to do then?
Nothing. Just hope and pray.
Oh, yeah. They're a little bit ahead of their time. Yeah. Oh, Just what I was afraid of. The vessels have ruptured, and that's very serious.
Daddy, I'll be back soon.
What?
Oh.
Where's Mummy going?
Well?
Hey.
He has a fever. But there's really no need to worry. I'll arrange everything that's necessary. I shall return.
Where's he gone?
Here I am.
Here you are. Just what we need.
But what have you got there? Do you really think that's going to cure him?
And then give him this. And just for good measure, he's to eat all this as well. Now, where is it? Oh, yes, this as well. That's delicious, that.
But,
No arguments. He must follow this diet for 5 or 6 days, and then he'll be perfectly all right again.
Look what I brought the invalid.
Vitamin C, 400 milligrams. Very good. Let them through.
It's okay. You can come. Nice and solid.
They're nearly finished. All's well that ends well. Although we did get quite a fright.
Oh. 110 grams of proteins and 300 calories of fat. Good! That's marvelous!
Let's see what's happening in the liver.
To execute your order for cholesterol, Maestro, I need lipids and fatty acids. And it's not my fault if I haven't got any. I can't manufacture them, can I?
I've never heard such impertinence. What school did you go to, hey? And if you were given an order, it means the materials are on their way.
Ooh, here's the promised delivery of lipids, sir.
Well, what do you think you're waiting for? Start making up the cholesterol order immediately.
Good. How's it going in your sector?
Not very well.
And why not?
I've been asked to look after the fat reserves, and I'd like to, but you can't really call these reserves, can you? I mean, do you perhaps know if there's going to be a delivery soon? Just a little bit for my reserves, sir.
And what's that down there?
Oh, goody! Reserves!
Hi there! And about time, too, we were getting lonely. Now we can have some fun!
Good morning!
Ah! Well, I'm feeling much better now.
After all, he won't do me any harm either.
Many thanks. Thank you.
Do you see those berries? They're very good for you, and they're full of vitamins. I assure you they are.
Yes, but one had to know that.
That's true, and it took a long time to find out.
No, 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 no! Oh, no. Oh, too late.
Life wasn't easy for our ancestors.
Far from it.
They were always starving. There was never enough food. Life was difficult, and they worked very hard. They had barely enough to eat to replace the energy they used up. Many of them died of epidemics or scurvy. Scurvy! We need fresh vegetables and fruit.
But, Grandpapa, one's always hearing about the huge feasts and gargantuan meals of the Middle Ages, and even before.
Reserved for the elite, yes, for the noblemen, princes, and kings. For the common man, it was quite different. And don't forget, my boy, that even the elite had to extend themselves, set examples. Physical effort was the common lot to a degree we can't imagine. And fighting aside, the brave crusaders covered tens of thousands of kilometers on foot. Who could do that today? Nowadays, everything is easy. Too easy, in fact, in our modern countries. We have motor cars or public transport, a sedentary life, food that's too rich and too much of it, not enough physical exercise. Yes, everything's become too easy. And hidden in the depths of our body's cells, the chain of life which rules our existence has difficulty functioning well. It's not made for this kind of imbalance.
So, if we learn to treat our cells well and nourish them properly, they should last forever, shouldn't they, Grandpapa?
They'll last better and much longer, but forever. There's constant renewal as we grow, but as we get older, our cells become tired. That's inevitable, just as does our whole system.
Look! Aha! Good.
Oh, that looks good.
It is good.
Look there, Grandpapa.
Eh? Does that make you hungry?
Yes, it does a bit.
Are you still hungry?
No, not really, but it's as though I...
It's as though you have a desire or a need.
Yes, it's a bit like that.
If only I could explain to you what's going on right now in your system, in your brain.
Reserves of sugar and fats are sufficient. Reserves of protein also sufficient. Shall we cut the appetite?
All right. Yes, do.
Cut the appetite to be transmitted at once.
Immediately? That's pretty quick. I mean, even in our modern times, it's going to take a little while before the message reaches its destination. Meantime, anything could happen. They could have allowed us a bit of cake. After all, a growing body needs quite a bit of sugar. Nourishment in sight.
Yes, I see it.
Give the order to seize it.
Order from the primitive brain. Nourishment in sight. To be seized.
But what's he doing, the old fossil? The nincompoop. We've got enough food. Cut the appetite, you bearded old goat. There's never enough food, and one must seize it whenever one can. And you're a bearded old goat yourself. Do you want to say that again, you hairy pterodactyl? Just you dare try and stop
me. Yes,
the
orders received by the brain aren't always simple. Memories and ancient instincts still exist, which the modern brain can't always subdue, you see. There you are. This can't do you much harm.
Fats, 230 calories. Proteins, 130. Sugars, just over 200. Stop! No more fats. That's plenty of calories. And the vitamins, not too many now. Oh, well, that'll do. That's enough! No more fats! No more sugars! Stop! We're not using enough energy! We are eating too much!
Did you hear that? He's never, ever happy, that guy. If there's not enough, he sniffles. If there's too much, he complains.
It's not easy keeping the right balance. No, the right balance isn't easy. And the excesses which accumulate become as dangerous as the scarcities.
Mm-hmm.
We eat so often in our lives.
About 70,000 times. Right? And all that food comes from the sun?
Oh, yes. Oh. Even meat. Milk, cheese, vegetables, fruit, the oxygen we breathe. Yes, everything that nourishes our cells comes from the sun. Peter, don't you think he'll become a fatty like his master with no exercise and eating too much?